The end of times. The end of times. Human behavioral and prophetic signs. Signs that already had been prophesied before you were born. Things that God declared aforetime that must happen, and that when we see them happening, then we should realize that the end is just too close. 2 Timothy chapter 3 talks about the last days and perilous times. Men shall be lovers of themselves more than lovers of God. Men shall love pleasures. Women shall love pleasures. People shall be unthankful. People shall even criticize those that are doing good. And all other things we saw, including perversions, people engaging in unnatural human behaviors as it pertains to immorality. Other prophecies of the Bible as to signs that we should look out for, and when we see them happening, then we realize that the end is just very near. Hebrews chapter 1 verses 1 and 2, and then Matthew chapter 24 from verse 33, we'll read through to verse 39. Now, in Hebrews, we are meant to know that God has been speaking unto his people. But in our own generation, he decided to speak to us by his Son. Why? Because our generation is the last generation, and a very fortunate generation. A generation of the dispensation of grace, not a generation of the dispensation of the law. Therefore, this makes us highly privileged. Highly privileged that God decided to speak to us by his Son. If anybody fails to listen to what God is saying by his, through his Son, or by the mouth of his Son, that person will blame himself or herself. Now, in Matthew chapter 24, we have read a part of what his Son said. The Son of God directly now speaking in John 24, where we have read, he expressed a lot of things, but of particular importance is this verse 33. So likewise he, when ye shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. Now, before he made this comment, he had shown some signs that will happen. But he said that these signs are beginning of sorrows, not the end of sorrows. But there is that these things will be happening and happening sequentially. But when it gets to a point, then you now know. That it is at the door. Why are we amplifying all this? Why are we talking about the coming of Jesus? Why are we shouting? Why are we lamenting? Why are we saying every person get ready? We are saying get ready because we know that if you miss the opportunity of rapture, there cannot be a second rapture. If you miss it once, you have missed it. And God is not a respecter of persons. And on the day of rapture, there won't be explanations. There will be no time to explain yourself as to why you are not ready. So know ye that the day is closer than you can ever imagine. Let me say here that the signs which we have seen and are stated in the Bible, all of them, especially the signs stated in Matthew 24, all of them are to be fulfilled in this generation. One generation. There are no two generations. We are only given signs. When you see these signs, then know that the time is up. Get ready. Because your flight can be in the night, it can be in the morning, it can be when people are asleep. Your flight can be when you are in the farm, or when you are in the shop, or when you are at school, or wherever. So, be ever ready. The aim, what the Lord is wanting to achieve, is for you to see the truth as the urgency, and then let that awareness create positive fear in you, and let that fear make you check your life and amend your ways. That's the essence. So God is working. God is using many people, pushing the gospel into those hinterlands, into communities, into places where the gospel had not reached. And these things will continue to thrive and continue to thrive. So if you think that the gospel must be preached physically, no. The gospel can be preached through the print media, can be preached through the, you know, through the through other means. Send, so that at the end of the day, nobody will have any excuse to say, God, why we didn't repent? Well, because the gospel didn't reach our land. So brethren, with all of this, what can we say? We can say in conclusion that the prophecies declared in the Bible as to things that when we see them happening, we will see and we will confirm that the coming of Jesus is close, even at the door. Almost all those prophecies have taken place, and they are still taking place. They are happening. Let's read Matthew 24 verse 33. So likewise ye, when you shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be fulfilled. Having seen this, what is your decision? Why are you still delaying your salvation? Why are you still delaying your sanctification? Why are you still delaying the restitution? Why are you still waiting? What are you waiting for? Why are you still engaging in activities that you know will not encourage you or help you to make the rapture? Why? If you miss the rapture, who will you blame? Will you blame your brother? Will you blame your sister? Will you blame your husband? Or you blame your wife? Or you blame your colleague? Or you blame your neighbor? Or you blame your pastor? Or pastor, you blame your member? Who will you blame? Or you blame Satan? You blame demons? Who will you blame? Definitely, you will blame yourself. But the door is open now. The chance is there for you to say, Lord, having seen these signs, I will wait no longer. I want to make amends. I correct my ways. I mend my life. I check myself. If there is anything that is there in my life that is not in order, Lord, I put it right. Please stop making excuses. Admit, acknowledge your fault, and step forward and say to God, it's better for me to swallow my pride and take the shame and get my life corrected now and get ready for the kingdom and get ready for Jesus than for me to remain in my position and remain in my situation and remain in my lifestyle because of not wanting people to look at me, not wanting people to see me. And then you allow the sin to remain. My beloved, do whatsoever that you can do. Humble yourself if it's needful to do so. Cry out if that is what you need to do. One of the apostles, I think Apostle James said, knowing therefore the terror of God, we persuade men. We persuade men. Are you there? You are living in sin. You are enjoying yourself, enjoying the flesh, enjoying pleasure. And the devil is telling you, if you go and give your life to Jesus now, how will it look like? You will deny, you will lose this, you will lose that, you will lose this, you will lose that. And you are agreeing with him. That same devil that is telling you that is the same person that will admit you into hell when you die. Then you say, but this was the voice that I was hearing when I wanted to go to the altar and give my life to Christ. It was this your voice that stopped me. He will laugh and laugh and laugh and tell you that you are personally responsible for all the decisions you took on earth and all the choices you made on earth, that you are accountable, that he only suggested to you. He didn't force you. He made a suggestion that you shouldn't go for altar call, and then you agreed and refused to go for altar call. He will ask you, did I force you? Did I push you? Did I change your legs? I made a suggestion to you in your heart. Say, madam, don't go. You'll be ashamed. Man, don't go. You'll be ashamed. And you agree with me. You are the one that took the decision. So take responsibility. And you will cry. If I had known, I would have surrendered. But this is the time that you shouldn't cry if I had known. But this is the time you should cry and say, thank God I am here. Thank God I have the opportunity of surrendering my life to Jesus so that Christ will be formed in me, so that my sins will be forgiven. But if you say, no, let me continue to enjoy this world soon and very soon, he that will come. But even if he doesn't come in the next 1 week, 1 month, or 1 year, you may die to meet him in the next 1 week, 1 year, or less. Therefore, it's time to give your life to Christ. Young people, elderly people, older people in the church, leaders, workers, everybody, check your life, because the coming of Jesus is close, is at the doors. So I want you to have the opportunity and pray. And you are there, you want to give your life to Jesus. You want to give your life to Jesus, come. You have seen it. You want to give your life to Jesus, come over. Backslider, come. Christian brother that has returned to immorality, come. Sister that returned to immorality, come. Time is passing. The door is open now. But soon the door will be closed. Come before the door is closed against you. Jesus is calling you. You are a believer. You are there. But you are not guarding yourself. You are living an unguarded life. You believe that it will take place, but it will be sometime in the far future. Lord, there are joining multitudes. There is a passing away. There is a falling away. There is a falling away in Christianity right now. There is backsliding.
Don't join the backsliding multitude. There is backsliding, high level backsliding. There is high level backsliding. Even among ministers. Any way or ways of doing things that are contrary to the Bible, no matter who is engaging in that way or those ways, that way or ways of doing things is satanic. If you copy it, you have accepted Satan. Remember that you will be held responsible for whatsoever decision or choices that you make. You will be held personally responsible. Don't blame anybody.